Good day, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American stock markets using weekly charts. Using weekly charts, we're able to filter out all of that noise from Monday to Friday and just look at long-term changes in the direction of the markets. Now, as you're probably aware, we are currently in a seasonally weak period for the stock market. September and October have historically been not only weak months for the stock market, but very volatile months for the stock market. And this year, I think we've got something extra that we don't usually see, and that is being hit by all of these storms. We had the storm in Texas that the people of Texas are still dealing with, of course, and now this weekend Florida is being hit. And then we've got another storm coming after Irene called Jose, and we don't know exactly what the direction of Jose is just yet, but it is heading towards land at the moment. So when you have these many storms in a row, of course, you've got a lot of people that are going to have to clean up and possibly rebuild after the storm. And while it might be good for the hardware stores, I don't see these people wanting to buy stocks anytime soon. In fact, I think a lot of them are going to have to sell some stocks to help finance the cleanup and the rebuilding of their properties. And while that might not cause the stock market to crash, it's certainly not going to help the stock market go forward. And we have had trouble going forward over the past few months. Now, something that's broken at the moment is the U.S. dollar. And 2017, one of the best trades of the year is just to short the U.S. dollar. And it continued to move lower last week, making a new low for 2017. We're also seeing money go back into the bond market. And bonds have been up the past few weeks and made a new high for 2017 last week. And that's not a good sign for the stock market if money is hiding in the bond market. And there we have gold making a new high for 2017 this week. 1375 is our next target to the upside. It is also the 2016 high. So just be aware of that. We're coming up to a major area of resistance. Of course, a breakout above that is probably not good for the rest of the market, but certainly good for people invested in gold. Now, in 2016, the Canadian stock market had smooth sailing. During this period, we had several weeks that we traded through the lower channel line, but we never actually closed below it. So we never generated a weekly sell signal. But this year in 2017, we're having a lot of trouble, and we've been on a weekly sell signal for a while now, and now we're looking to see if we can hold the summer lows. Looking at the U.S. market, the VIX has been on a buy signal for the last 5 weeks. It came down to the lower channel line the previous week, but did not close below it, so we're still looking for a close below 1013 this coming Friday. If we could get a close below there, then we would know that fear is starting to dissipate from the major market participants, but that's not what it's looking at right now. And there's the S&P 500 inside week last week. We're still trying to break over 2,500 and have been unable to do so, and now we're entering this weak period for the market, so it may take some time before we get back to testing the 2,500 level. The NASDAQ 100, of course, which continues to outperform the S&P 500, has really no banking stocks in the NASDAQ 100 and has a bunch of biotechs that make up a much bigger percentage of the NASDAQ than they do in the S&P 500. So that's why you see that discrepancy. Now, of the big NASDAQ stocks that people follow, Apple Computer, Facebook, and Netflix are still on weekly buy signals. But Amazon and Google are already on weekly sell signals and did not come back last week. So just be aware that some of these big cap NASDAQ stocks are starting to break down. Semiconductors still on a weekly buy signal, but notice how long ago it was that the SOX index peaked back here in May, and we still have not been able to take out that high. So inside week last week, traded back into the channel. We're not too worried about a sell signal right now. And there's biotech stocks, had a big pop on the previous week and then very quiet trading last week, but still on a weekly buy signal here. What you need to really be concerned about is those bank stocks, and the bank stocks came down hard last week, heading towards $88. 88 has dollars on the KBW banking index, has acted as support in 2017, and so we'll look to see if that level holds, the $88 level. Looking at the Canadian banking sector, we have not had any upward momentum for a long time. You can see when Canadian bank stocks peaked, and then if we go back, you can see that U.S. bank stocks peaked the next week. Again, Canadian bank stocks have not been able to generate any upward momentum for quite a while now, and we made a new low for this move last week. There is the low from back in May of this year, and of course that will act as a major target and a major potential area of support. Energy stocks. Now, energy stocks have been moving up they moved up for 2 weeks in a row. They traded higher last week, but then lost some of that momentum going into the end of the week and closed lower on the week in Canada, higher on the week in the U.S. But unfortunately, energy stocks have not been able to save us. Looking at the week ahead for the VIX, we need to close below $11.18. If we can get that, that would certainly be very positive for the market. S&P 500, the Spider ETF, still on a buy signal. I've been treading water for the last few days up at the upper channel line. The first close below 245.37 would give us a sell signal there. Now that lower channel line is going to continue to rise during the week. For the Qs, we're looking for a daily close below 143.54. And for the TSX, we're looking in the opposite direction. We're down at the recent low there, and we need to close on Monday above 22.30. And of course, that upper channel line is curling down, and it will continue to move lower daily. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. Something's going to break soon. Don't know when that's going to happen. I certainly would not be enthusiastic to put new money into the stock market right now. Something's going to crack and pop over the next few weeks. Just don't know when it's going to start. And you need to be in cash or short the market when that happens. When we do start to see daily sell signals for the major U.S. indexes, we'll flip over and start looking at the bear ETFs. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning.